Hello everybody, this is Francesc Verdugo and today we are going to talk about the Gridap project and new tools to solve PDEs in Julia. Gridap is a Julia package to solve partial differential equations or PDEs using different types of finite element methods. And here, just as an example, you can see some PDEs we have solved with the library during the last months. The Gridap project was initially introduced to the Julia community last year, JuliaCon. You can check out this video for further details. And today we're going to discuss about the new tools we have added into the library since then. In particular, I'm going to show the new user API and also some performance improvements. Then Eric Neiva is going to discuss how to solve PDEs on complex geometries. And finally, Uriel Colomés is going to show how he's using the library to solve real-world applications. So now let's get started. And regarding the new user API, I would like to mention that we have improved the way the user writes down the weak form of the problem. And you can see this with that particular example. So for the Poisson equation, the user can specify the weak form by writing down these two Julia functions with a syntax very close to the mathematical notation. And of course, this API not only works for this very simple example, but also it also works in much more complex scenarios. For instance, for multi-field PDEs, like the Stokes equation, the user again can specify the weak form in a very compact way. And even in multi-field nonlinear PDEs, like the incompressible Navier-Stokes equation, the user can specify the weak residual and the corresponding weak Jacobian in a very compact notation. I think that these examples make clear that with the latest version of Gridap, one can specify complex weak forms in a convenient way, but the question is how efficient is the resulting finite element code? And the answer is that we have been improving the performance of the latest version. So you can see this with that example. Here I'm showing the CPU time needed to assemble a linear system for the Poisson equation versus problem size. And as you can see, we have been reducing CPU times. And if you compare the version we presented in last year's JuliaCon with respect to the version with the latest Gridap version, we have achieved more than a factor 4 of improvement, which I believe is quite significant. And thanks to that work, if you compare with Phoenix, now we are as fast as the latest version of Phoenix, which shows that with Gridap, which is a package fully implemented in Julia, we are starting to be as efficient as other finite element codes implemented in languages like C and C++.
Hi there, Eric here. If you want to simulate complex geometries in Gridap, there are two packages that can help you. If you want to mesh the geometry, Gridap Gmesh is your choice. Otherwise, Gridap Embedded is there for you. Gridap Gmesh lets you import into Gridap a mesh generated by Gmesh, a well-known open source finite element mesh generator. Usage in Gridap is very straightforward. You just need to convert the Gmesh into a native Gridap model. From here, all Gridap functionality is available for you. And here is the solution of the previous example. Concerning Gridap Embedded, you can use two different embedded finite element methods, aggregated FEM or ghost penalty FEM, described in the references below. You can have an implicit representation of the geometry with level set surface descriptions. Gridap Embedded has already a library of level sets implemented for you, but you can also extend it with a new implementation of your choice. You can also perform Boolean operations on the primitive level set functions to construct more complex geometries, such as this one here, or these Olympic rings. As with Gridap, the user can express a Gridap embedded simulation in a very compact way. Let's see how to do it in a Poisson problem defined in an embedded disk. We will only focus on the particularities of embedded simulations. The first thing to do is to define the embedded geometry. The background model can be as simple as a Cartesian grid. Then we need to cut the background model to generate the meshes where we will integrate the weak form. An aggregated finite element space can be readily defined from a standard wand, and we can also write our weak form with weak Dirichlet boundary conditions as usually done in embedded methods. From here, we can solve and represent our solution with the same API provided by Gridap.
Okay, so Francesc and Eric have presented these very nice features of Gridap, and now I'll show you that Gridap also can be used to solve real-world applications. This is, for instance, a simulation of a simplified floating solar farm that have been solved using Gridap. In this type of applications, we face several challenges. One of them is that we have a mixed dimensional PDE. Okay, so here we have a variable that is defined in a two-dimensional domain, coupled with another variable that's only defined in a one-dimensional domain, a part of the boundary. Gridap offers the possibility to solve these kind of problems by providing this boundary discrete model that constructs a discrete model or a part of the boundary of the domain. Also, another challenge that we have here in this type of applications is that we want to solve a problem with multiple finite element spaces linked together. So we have the option to define this multi-field finite element space function where we send a vector of single field finite element spaces that can be defined in different domains and different dimensions. Another challenge that we have here is that this is a transient problem, so we need tools to solve first and second order ODEs. So Gridap has this Gridap ODEs package in which that extends all the Gridap machinery into the transient problems. Okay, so for instance, this is the code that you would implement in a Gridap to solve a second order ODE, a linear second order ODE. Here we are sending the contributions from the mass, damping and stiffness matrices together with the finite element spaces. And finally, you can have problems where you have highly nonlinear terms or you have nonlinearities. And in that case, Gridap allows to use automatic differentiation. Okay? So this is, for instance, the residual that you would get for a fluid structure interaction problem where you have several variables interacting between each other and where you have the contribution of highly nonlinear terms. So to derive the finite element operator, we would need the residual, but also the Jacobian with respect to the unknown and the Jacobian with respect to the time derivative. So this can be done, obtained manually, deriving the Jacobian, but it's time-consuming and it's prone to introduce errors. And Gridap offers the option to use this forward if package in which we can forget about the Jacobian and just define the finite element operator based on the residual and the finite element spaces. And that's all I wanted to show. You have more examples in Gridap tutorials, and if you are willing to contribute, you are more than welcome. And that's all from our side. Thank you very much.